And I'm Chris.
And we're here at Dorney Park for another segment of Career Gates. Today, we're going to talk about technology.
That's right. We're going to talk about the role of technology in today's job market.
So check it out.
There's a bee there. If it comes close to me, I might scream.
I had a dream that I ran away. Then I started to fly. I woke up downstream. Well, I promised someday that I'd give it a try.
Technology is becoming more and more an important aspect of the business.
It's huge.
Technology is huge.
Technology plays a big role in our facility.
Technology is very important.
Technology is so important.
Technology is critical.
Technology is changing.
It's always changing.
Technology is ever changing.
If you take a calendar and put a penny on the first day of the month and double that penny every day, by the time you're at the 23rd of the month, you have $43,000. Approximately the median household income of the United States. By the end of the month, you have almost $12 million. That's how technology is. We're at the 23rd of the month. The next few years are going to see amazing, fantastic growth in technology.
Technology.
Advancements here at Rexroth, everything with the manufacturing side is going computers.
Been here with 18 years, and when I first started, we designed and everything on the board. Everything was paper and pencil.
You couldn't tell what was going on until you actually physically got on the shop floor.
As the technology went on, and we continued and moved forward, came the 3D CAD. It has really sped up our ability to take a design that was maybe 40 hours worth of manual labor to today's industry. It's really in about half that time or less.
The technology today now allows us to do this, and then we can check now, make sure everything's going to run and run correctly. It saves a lot of time, a lot of trial and error, and we can get it right the first time.
Technology has been a big asset to our profession.
Here at the rehab hospital, we have many advances in technology, such as something called the Robomatica, which is very much like a treadmill, but it has a harness to help people who have had strokes or have weakness learn to walk again. It stimulates the muscles in their legs and their body to send the signal back to their brain to help retrain their body on how to walk.
For someone with a stroke or spinal cord injury, we can have them walk in where 20, 30 years ago, it'd be a lot more difficult and a lot more manpower.
In allied health professions, it's very, very important.
They're always coming out with new devices.
Everything is done with the computerization.
The whole machine itself is basically computerized. While the machine's pulling from the bottom and the top, what it's doing is getting blood and oxygen in between the discs, and it's going like this to your spine. It's actually taking the spine and going like this, and it's pumping the discs back and forth. So it's really cool because it's getting your body all vascular and getting the blood going. And we put the patient on the machine, and it knows based on half their body weight minus 10 pounds is where we start the tension of the pull, and it pulls them very scientifically, so if the data has to be correct, and it is, you know, very data oriented.
Technology plays a really important role in our job. Technology will help a lot to diagnose patients with their disease and to help find the best treatment for them.
On a day-to-day basis, I see people who have no speech. Anything that they want to do, we can help them using technology in many different ways. What's very exciting for me is there's newer and newer technology that allows people to use computers, communication devices, just by moving their eyeballs. Communication skills can be taught, they can be enhanced. Any aspect of communication can be learned through the computers. With this particular case, you type in your message, and then when you're ready to speak, you hit the top. I did have a person that I worked with. The first thing that they said to me with their device was, "I love you." And that really was really meaningful.
As we continue to evolve in the medical practice, more and more things will be automated, and we'll continue to use technology.
Now with today's jobs, there's a lot more interaction with our operators and technology. Our necks are very complex shapes. These used to be manufactured by hand. We would cut pieces of wood and operators would use a draw knife. But now that we're making 300 necks a day, we use computer numerically controlled machines. We're really proud of this piece of technology that we put in. This is our polishing robot. Basically, the robot will take a guitar body or a guitar neck, and it will go through the process of doing first the back, then the side, then the top.
In this particular operation, all of our forklift operators have computers on their forklifts. Most of the work is done in scanning barcodes. It allows us to be more productive in the warehouse operations and have much better data than we had in the past.
They'll scan the location, it'll tell them what level to put the material in.
It helps us on a wireless system where it's less paperwork.
A lot of the old go out and take this piece of paper and check it off, that's gone away.
We have better tracking. Every case in this building is tracked as it moves throughout the warehouse. We can track the product from the moment it comes in. It's real-time tracking, so as people scan a pallet, you know immediately what lift it's on and where it's at within the warehouse.
That technology didn't exist several years ago.
In the next 5 to 10 years, it's going to continue to and increase in importance.
So technology is definitely the wave of the future.
We need the brightest minds, we need the cleverest people, and we need those people who understand what technology is all about, because it is exploding. Those who know the most about technology are the ones who will make a difference in the future.
Yeah, I'm on my way.
So if you want to find out more about these and other cool jobs in the Lehigh Valley, please check us out at www.careercruising.com.
And www.careerlinklehighvalley.org.
Thanks for hanging out with us.
See you next time.
Hi, I'm Elmer Gates, chairman of Embassy Bank for the Lehigh Valley. As you can see, I'm standing in front of the shuttered gates of Bethlehem Steel. The Lehigh Valley Workforce Investment Board and PBS 39 are proud to present Career Gates, which will show you there have been a number of other industries across the spectrum that have expanded, as a matter of fact, the workforce that used to work here. You, too, can take advantage of this wonderful opportunity that's here now and will continue to be here for years to come.